you stay up all night. All night. Fuck me to the bed.
Man post a quote and a pic in bed, so I hit them in the DM like, hey big head, remember when I was your woman crush? He said yeah, told him that I'm headed home, he could meet me there, try to beat me.
They said Doja hit so sticky, I said thank you very much, bent the whole world over and says thank you very much.
I dropped my contour stick on the ground, so it's all messed up, but I'm still gonna use it because this is the only shade I have, and these are really hard to find. There's a link in my bio though where you can find this contour stick. So we're gonna do a brown glitter look today. I worked today and I just got off work, and we're gonna do this glitter look. I feel like this brown glitter look will be good for like going out in Vegas if it's your birthday, something like that, you know. Got my Red Bull. I just got back from the gas station. I also picked up the CBD sparkling water. It has 30 milligrams of CBD. I really like eating the CBD gummies before bed because I have a really bad trouble sleeping. Oh, maybe it's because I drink caffeine at 7 o'clock at night. Yeah, so that's unhealthy, but you know, I need something to help me sleep. I also have sleeping issues because of other reasons too, not just when I have caffeine, but yeah. I'm doing my brows now. I just did a review on this brow gel, obsessed. I'm gonna try on some wigs today, so that's why my hair looks disgusting, and I don't think I've ever shown you guys my hair up because I'm very, very insecure about my big forehead, and that's why I contour so harshly too on my forehead, because it's like a 5 head, but Tyra Banks, beautiful model, has a 5 head too, and she's embraced it, so I'm embracing mine. I've gotten really good at just not caring what people think, and so that's why most of my videos, you know, I don't look perfect because no one's perfect, and I want to show you guys that you can own your insecurities. I'm going to tell you guys what my insecurities are, and I own them, you know? Whatever. Juvia's Place Eye Primer. Taking the Sigma E25 brush. It's a blending brush. It works amazing. And then I'm going to take the James Charles palette, and I'm going to mix these two orange shades together. Mostly this one, though. And I'm just gonna start blending that in the crease, just lightly. So I just built up the orange shade, and then I'm gonna take this NYX glitter. It's in 08. I actually really like NYX's glitters. So I just got my brush wet, and then I packed the glitter on, and then I'm just gonna pack it on. Wow, that is so pretty. Oh yeah. Let me know what glitter shade I should do next in the comments, and I will do them for you. But I just had this brown glitter, so I thought I'd do that. Ooh, so pretty. I really love the orange crease shade, but I'm gonna add some dark brown. With a small brush, I'm just gonna take this dark brown shade. Go to part two.
How Zodiac signs act on the first day of school, part one. Hold up, how's my cousin if you don't follow me on Instagram, child? Do that. Oh my gosh, Raekwon, you just stepped on my all white forces.
My bad, Zaquita.
What do you mean, my bad? Call your mother. She's about to buy me a new pair. Oh my god. Mushroom, what classes you got, girl?
Girl got health.
We don't got homework? Mr. Bartholomew, you knew we needed the same classes. What happened? Let me see who's gonna be in my homeroom. Mr. Bartholomew, no, can I go to the office and change my homeroom? Because I can't be in the class with these people.
Zach, what classes you got, Green?
Girl, I don't know. Let me get my schedule home. Girl, I got held back. Hold on, what am I gonna tell my mama?
Oh, girl, your mama about to beat you. Hey, talk away to Green.
What happened to all that mouth that you had during the summertime when I wasn't here?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, you better keep it cute before I knock your tooth out.
Whose tooth is you gonna knock out? Because Zaquita. Zaquita, run up. Run up. Zaquita. Zaquita, better act like you know who I am.
Sin cejas te ves hermosa.
Jade, solo quiero decir que agradezco mucho que almuerces con nosotros. Y gracias a André y Beck por esposar a Jade a la mesa.
No hay problema.
Todavía no entiendo qué pasó.
Jade me pidió que arreglara sus cejas e intenté depilarlas, pero cuando retiré las tiras de cera hubo un problema.
¡Desaparecieron mis cejas!
¡No es cierto! ¡Ya te dije que aquí están!
Time trying to build a home with an earth sign, trying to be at home doing curves. I love you on your best days, happy on your worst nights.
I'm sick. I'm sorry, I can't.
You can dance, you can jive.
This is my song, but jealousy started following me.
Must be love on the brain.
Why are you taking my mic? I know I finished, but I have to sing another one.
Cause I'm in love with my future.
Feeling real tipsy, getting real freaky, and it's getting real frisky.
Maybach music.
Come, dance yourself. Come, up and down.
And then I get here sitting next to you. But after all,
we're bad guys. It's what we do.
Based on your rising sign, what should you be focusing on healing the most in this lifetime? Let's go. Each rising sign corresponds with different parts of the body, and those parts of the body and the areas of life they affect are going to be so crucial for you to focus on healing in this lifetime. This will help you achieve your most empowered you and your most healed self. Aries risings, it's important for you to focus on healing the mind and the brain and memory, the head, anything about the face, the teeth, the hair, and blood. But going back to that crucial one, the mind, it's important for you to meditate, open your mind, clear your mind. It's important for you to do brain and memory exercises and for you to keep your energy high vibe and high energy. Healing the mind can be using different spiritual practices or going to a therapist, anything that helps you to stay cool and clear-minded. Taurus risings, it's really important for you to focus on the neck and the shoulders, relieving yourself of all that tension, getting massages, doing exercises and yoga will really help you to open up the neck and shoulders. It will help you stand better, your posture. Doing this will help you with your confidence and you will feel your best. Make sure you are taking care of your throat, your vocal cords, and making sure your thymus gland is healthy. Gemini risings, again, the throat is important for you to take good care of, but also more importantly, your lungs. Doing lots of breath work will help you heal in this life. It will help you to use your voice, speak up for yourself, all of those things Geminis are really well known for. Taking great care of the nervous system through any type of healing that helps with that. A lot of times meditation and yoga, that kind of stuff really helps the nervous system. So again, that would be a great method for you. Cancer, your area of the body is the chest and the womb. It's really important for you to do any emotional healing around those areas of the body connected to motherhood, whether that's now or later on in your life. It's important for you to take good care of your lymphatic system. Getting lymphatic massages would really, really help you. Look into ways to heal your womb on a spiritual level and on a physical level. Again, with the reproductive organs, that's really important that you are taking care on an emotional and spiritual level and on a physical level. Getting checked up is important. Leo risings, your area of the body is the heart. So making sure you're doing lots of heart healing, heart opening, and making sure that your heart and your blood pressure are in check. Also, the spine, making sure you're doing any type of spine alignments, whether that's on a physical scale, going to the chiropractor, or more on a spiritual scale, doing yoga to align your spine, meditation even. Stay tuned for part two. Part two of what you should be focusing on healing based on your rising sign. Virgo risings, it's important for you to focus on your gut health, your digestive system, and your stomach and intestines. So making sure you're eating clean, nutritious foods will help you feel your best and to heal the physical, which will help you heal emotionally and spiritually as well. Make sure you are exercising so you can feel your best. Libra risings, your area of the body are the kidneys. So making sure that you are physically detoxing your kidneys will help you, but on an emotional and spiritual level, kidneys store anger. So helping yourself by releasing anger through meditation or any other spiritual practice will really help you as well. Even therapy would help you. You also would benefit from doing lower back massages and butt exercises to help that booty be popping. Scorpio risings, your area of the body is the hips and the reproductive organs. So making sure you're doing hip opening exercises to release trauma and to heal on a spiritual and emotional level will also benefit you. But just in general, opening up the hips is good physically as well. Making sure that you are working on your confidence about your body and about your sexuality and really releasing any pain or trauma around that area of your life is important. Sagittarius risings, your area of the body is the liver, and the liver stores stress, and it's really important for you to detox your liver, make sure that your habits are healthy and supporting liver health, and also releasing stress overall, doing any type of spiritual practice to help you relieve stress, any type of self-care practice in general is good for you. You also rule the thighs and the legs. So walking, any type of exercise that will help strengthen your legs. Leg day is in for you, Sagittarius. Capricorn risings, your part of the body is the bones and the joints. So making sure you are stretching and making yourself extra flexible is going to help you to feel your best. Capricorn rising, you also rule the hair and the skin. So just making sure your self-care practices, skincare and hair care, are on point. Aquarius risings, yours is very similar to Capricorn risings. It's going to sound a bit repetitive, but stretches, yoga, flexibility, anything that helps you to open up your bones and joints is going to help you as well. Aquarius risings, your area of focus is going to be more focused on balance, while Capricorn's is more focused on the joint and bone health overall. And lastly, Pisces risings, your area of focus is going to be on the pineal gland, opening up the third eye. Look up third eye detoxing and get hand and foot massages.
You're breaking up with me because I work too hard? I'm sorry, I didn't know you wanted to live in an apartment deluxe cardboard box. So you're breaking up with me because my lack of emotional support? You want me to cry with you or help you? So you're breaking up with me because I sleep too much and I get too clingy? So you want me to sleep with other people? So you're breaking up with me because my expectations are too high? Well, obviously you failed the assignment. Good riddance. So you're done with me because every time you point out my flaws, I hurt your feelings? Well, I'm aggressively sensitive. Done with me because I lose interest quick and I need to be entertained by you like a TV show? Well, then cancel the show and make a better one. Done with me because I'm over dramatic and won't open up? You gotta put in time with me. I'm an emotional gangster, no tears, no tissue. So you're done with me because I treat you like you're my loyal servant and talk about myself too much? I don't see the problem. So you're done with me because I overanalyze everything you do and I live in my own head? I'm just triple checking that you're not a serial killer. So you're breaking up with me because I have a hard time taking things seriously? So you're boring and I made the wrong choice. Gotcha. You're done with me because I get way too intense in relationships? Thought we were just fuck buddies? No, these are soul ties, soul buddies. So you're done with me because I self-sabotage the relationship to see how far I can push you? Acting like you never took a test. Study for it then.
That's what they do, okay? They act like they love you. They act like they'll be there forever. And then one day they'll pack up all their stuff and move away and take their love with them.
You're mine.
He gon' die, yeah, I'm out of threat,
yeah.
Off of that bitch, I'ma lay up,
yeah.
I get the money, no lay up,
yeah.
I move the pack through the mail,
yeah.
She give me bread till I mail,
no.
Off of that bitch, I'ma lay up,
yeah.
I mean, she even cooks me pancakes and I've been salsa when my tummy aches. If that ain't love, then I don't know what love is. Even got a secret handshake, and she loves the music that my band makes. I know I'm young, but if I had to choose her or the sun, I'd be one nocturnal son of a gun.
Take a look at my girlfriend, she's the only one I got.
Here's what kind of alcohol I think you are based on your zodiac sign. Taurus, you are beer, piss water at its finest, tastes like shit, makes people burp. Ah, Gemini, a vodka Red Bull. Mixing a depressant with an energy drink makes for an angry drunk. Scorpio, you are whiskey, you probably drink it straight and you scare me. Are you gonna fight someone? Probably. Libra, you are champagne because you love to celebrate and you love to socialize. Aquarius, you're a Cosmo because you want to look more intelligent than you actually are. Cancer, since you're an emotional roller coaster, you deserve wine, because wine has taken many of us on emotional roller coasters. And you're always crying. Leo, you're tequila. Love this for you. Always the center of attention and no one can say no. We stan. Virgo, you're gin? Cause you're quirky? Or a serial killer. Sagittarius, you're a screwdriver? Cause you're extra and you live every day like it's bottomless brunch. Capricorn, we drink literally anything. And I can attest to that. You're reliable. Pisces, you drink absinthe.
Thank you.